Hey guys, hello and welcome to Zen Innovations. I have a car battery with me, and if you have some car battery lying around with you which you don't plan to use for say 6 to 8 months, then they can go bad. And in this video we are going to talk about how you can preserve your car batteries even if you don't use them for say 6 months, 1 year, something like that. Let me explain you with an example. Let's say you are going abroad for some projects, or maybe you got a job overseas and you will have to park your car for 6 months, 1 year, something like that. In that case, if you leave the battery inside the car, even if it's disconnected, the battery is going to go bad. Because what happens guys is that if the battery sits at a low state of charge, it's going to start a process known as sulphation. This is where sulphate crystals form on the plates, and eventually even if you manage to recharge the battery, you try to take it to the shop where you brought it from, the guy charges the battery, it works for say 2 or 3 weeks and then it again goes bad. And in that case, the battery is permanently gone and you will have to buy a new battery. So just to save you from that situation guys, I'm going to give you a golden tip where you can preserve the health of your batteries even if you don't use them for say 6 months or 1 year. Let's begin the video. Guys, for this procedure we are going to need a jumper cable. The links will be in description below so you can buy it online. And I assume everyone has an inverter. Let's check the car battery first. It has a negative side and a positive side. First we will connect the negative. I don't recommend you connect both poles at once because there's a chance of short circuit if both the clamps will touch. So first we will connect the negative side. And here is the negative clamp. And over here is our inverter battery. The battery will have negative marking on it. And as we can see here, it has a minus symbol. And often these terminals are black. Let's go to the positive side. As we can see, the positive marking is there on the battery. And let's firmly connect the clamp. Here is how the arrangement looks from above. We have one positive and one negative wire. Let's come back to the automotive battery and we will be connecting the positive now. As we can see, the cap is in red color and there is a plus symbol near to it. Let's connect the positive clamp. Connect the clamp firmly and securely. You don't want any loose contact here. There might be a very small spark, nothing to be afraid of. And let's check the voltage. So 13.47 volts, I think the perfect kind of trickle voltage for any medium or long term storage of batteries. A few important things to keep in mind before trying this fellas is that you need a 12 volt inverter system. So if you have a 24 volt inverter, this trick is not going to work. Other thing is that your battery chemistry should be the same. So my inverter battery and my automotive battery, both of them are lead acid batteries. Say if your car comes with a sealed maintenance free type battery or some lithium battery, then this tip should be avoided. That is it for this video guys. I hope you liked this tip. Make sure to share and subscribe. Have a nice day.